Crank it up. Greetings, travelers. This is Jim at the Mid-Nite Drive-Thru, and welcome back to Dishonored 2. We are in the Good Doctor chapter here at the Attermeyer Institute, blah, blah, blah. And we are here to do horrible things to people who have been traitors to their empress. Like so. Goodbye! I also killed him because he was making noise. Because that just apparently drives me crazy. I mean, not just slightly upset, but raving bonkers. So, let's get started, shall we? Now, Oh, hi. There's a person over there. All right, well, let's be reasonably sneaky. And oh, before we go too much further, let's go ahead and top that off, because that would be dumb. All right. Yeah, I think we're good to just go ahead and hop up and down here. Get our maximum distance. Boop. Kazooch! Yes, that'll do nicely. Yeah, well, you know, cry me a river, buddy. I guess we're full up on those. There seems to be a thingamabob somewhere nearby, so let's see if we can get any clues. Some there, some there. Something behind this wall somewhere. Down. Well, nothing back here, which is the important thing. So, poo. Poo on you! Nothing else of real value to me, at least. Nothing. That is nothing. Sounds horrible. We should probably do something about that. I don't know, like maybe go in and fight the blood flies since they're easy enough to kill with just a sword, you gutless wussies. Someone just heard a dog bark or something. Of course, now we're all on edge. Huh. Well, how about this? How about we do this? Cook this up a bit, and here you go. Okay, I seem to have knocked myself off, so I'm just gonna go ahead and pop back upside here. Okay, I guess I'll top my health off again. Gotta be on the lookout. Gotta be on the lookout, man. Cause you never know.
Hello? Anybody?
Hello?
Don't make me search the whole place. I don't have time for that.
You know what? If I say you have time for it, you have time for it.
Something's gotta give.
That would be your head has to give. Shaboomsk! Oh yeah. And away he goes! Say, I'm getting pretty good at this. Yeah. I mean, you know. Within reason. Rat skewer. Delish.
Oh, we did it. All right. shocker!
You won't get away!
I don't want to die!
Okay. That was messy. It was less than ideal. Potato. Right, there was something else to eat over here. Hang on a second. Another potato. And some fruit. Oh yeah, we're good. We're good. Stealthy? No. Not at all. But victorious. Positively. Oh, and a carrot. Hey, you know. Got a stinking carrot, man. All right, listen. I don't want to hurt you. I got no
reason
to.
Why should I trust someone who hides their face?
Look. Just nap, all right? I don't need your lip. And I don't need you running and making trouble for me. I will take whatever you got on you, though. Thanks. Yeah, just knock them unconscious if they're civilians. I'm not interested in killing civilians, you know? It's not my bag. Fish dumplings.
I just don't remember it being so many of them, and so big.
Shh. Stop talking about blood flies, you make me nervous. You too. See? Just unconscious. And broke. We demand the cure! Alright, well. Demand in one hand and crap in the other. See which one fills up first. I bet you can figure that out.
Ship chain is at midnight. Miss the boat and you get another ship without pay.
Well, that seems unfair. In the extreme. This just leads us back out to the main entryway here. But I seem to recall that I saw something when I was editing the other episode. Yes? Yes. Off you go now! Yeah. When I went up into the rafters from the main hall before. One fellow got past this door and then he just kind of stayed out here, which is why there was one fewer than I thought. It's because he was out here. Problem solved. Yay.
Clearly, Dr. Hypatia's not seeing patients anymore.
All right. Hey, you know? Chill. Hey, you! There you go. Let's see. What do we got over here? Unsent letter to family. Oh. To Emma, Philip, and little Edgar. Things haven't changed much since my last assignment at Attermeyer. Excepting I report to a different fellow now, and he's twice as strict. It's strange because there ain't really nothing for me to do. There's the doctor, but she just stays in and does her research. Maybe they need guards owing to the strange noises I hear at night. Not the usual creaks and groans a building makes. I feel any minute I might come around a corner and see something awful. But I don't want to worry you. I'll be back in a few days. Buy yourselves a nice fat chicken when you get this letter. Be good, Father. Well, I guess I should feel bad. right? I mean, the poor little ones aren't going to have a nice fat chicken. Maybe you should have thought of that before betraying your empress! Ah, yes. Now you don't get to go home. Chauncey! Away! You don't get to go home now. And your children, they get to eat rat kebab. Because you couldn't honor your agreement to serve the Empire. Yeah? Maybe next time you'll keep that in mind. Oh, wait. There won't be a next time. Because you're dead. Alright, you find anything, Chauncey? Oh, just a dog. Yeah, we're going to have to deal with him at some point. Either that or I could just leave him. I haven't decided. I kind of have this feeling of wanting to kill everyone on this island. But I could be compelled to show mercy to the dogs. Or rat dogs or whatever the heck they are. They're ugly. They are ugly. And being ugly can, on occasion, be a capital offense. I haven't decided if it is one today. I'll let you know what I decide. Basically what it comes down to, you know? You know, there's really nothing cuddly or cute about these dogs, but rune or bone charm nearby. Didn't we already address this? Right, there's one through there. And one down from me. What am I missing here? Oh, okay. Okay, that's good. Down we go. Shabutsk. Right. Lost and found it is. So this must be the one that was down from me, which looks like it's over here.
And this being nice. Dry and warm.
Rich crazy people get special treatment. How lovely. Gold. How nice. Well, she must be getting better because now she knows if she wants to appear sane, she's got to stop biting the attendants. Modern therapy is so heartwarming, isn't it? Anton has not fared well in the years since Dishonored 1. Anything else? No. Okay. Well, I'm satisfied.
I am tired. How long, my dears? How long must I endure in this shadow state?
I don't know. I don't know how to destroy the heart. If we get an option at the end, I will. A lot of blood flies. Something about bone charms. There you go. Let the patients sit outside. They'll enjoy that much better than being in here with the woman who hanged herself. We're assuming she hanged herself. I suppose it's possible somebody else hanged her, but yeah. You know, no thank you. No. Not interested. Let's see if we can clear out the terrace here. Alright, well there's one, two.
This was once my world. All things from the northernmost shores to here. Karnaka in the south.
Any chance I could get you guys to run interference for me there, Chauncey? Because that'd be great. Look, you're probably not going to like this, but this is how it's going to go. Yeah. Whoops. Sorry about that. It's just an accident. Other fella must have come in here. Where'd she go? And Danny would have gone if he had been corporeal long enough to hit the bottom. I will say, the ability to turn them into ash is useful, but it does detract somewhat from the satisfaction of their lifeless bodies collapsing to the ground below.
Yes, it does.
I feel cheated in a way. I mean, sure, I'll get over it, but it's just how I feel. A man's entitled to feel how he feels, you know. All right. Rune or bone charm nearby? Well, let's see. All right, well, there's some runes in here. Oh, yeah. A nice outsider shrine.
I so enjoy watching history warp as words pass from the lips of one to the ears of another. Imperfectly formed, half understood, poorly remembered. In the years to come, the story of the Crown Killer will be twisted and bent, hammered like soft metal.
Penguin.
By some accounts, a monster that had to be put down. By others, a victim of treachery, preserved, because in the end, you found another way. But you'll always remember the truth, won't you? Your truth, at least.
You know, I don't like him. I don't particularly care for him as the Penguin on Fox's Gotham. And I care for him even less in this configuration. All right, let's see. Is there anything else? Some bone charms down there, and there's two things up topside from here. Oh, I can't go out that way. Yes, I can. Just missed the entrance. All right, well, if they're topside, let's, let's get a leg up, shall we? Yeah, now you're talking. There and a bone charm on the roof. Perfect. Flies. I can't really be sure. Yeah, we might have some blowflies in here. Yeah, I don't think the button's gonna do any good since I busted the elevator. Sorry about that. Honest and for truth. 'Twas never my intent. Shaboosk. Let's see. Let me get up. Yes. There you go. Black bone charm. Alright, so we found regulars and we found corrupted, and now we found a black one. What is the significance of a black bone charm? Well, let's pretend I was going to try to replace this one. That's interesting. These all have like tiny. See what I mean? Like the description is in a narrow height, whereas maximum health is increased, like is huge. It's a very tall description box. So does that mean it's a much better bone charm? And that really raises a question. What do I want to do with regard to powers, because I'm doing pretty good with runes. I've got 7 on me now. And to be honest with you, although grabbing people through the air and pulling them toward me violently sounds like a lot of fun, my current method is working just fine. Deflecting things. See, I'm not... with the whole deflection thing, I'm not that good on the keyboard. Especially when I've got the keyboard jammed under the desk to try to fit while I'm doing this whole transparency bit. As a result, trying to deflect bullets... really? No, I'm a hack and slash kind of guy. That's just me. But bone charm crafting. Bloodthirst, yeah. Build up adrenaline. That's like forcing you to run madly at people. I don't like to do that. I like to select my target, take my time, and then strike. Bone charm, however, yeah, I think that could be useful. So it seems like superior crafting is the right place to start, and then well, I'm gonna definitely need to do that. So that leaves us down, so I can only do one of these now. But I don't really know what I'm gonna craft. So I guess the next thing to do is look at what charms I have. 6 pieces. Oh, look at that. Okay, I see now. This, the corrupt one, doesn't allow you to learn traits. Same thing with hardiness, the black bone charm. So corrupt or black ones, you don't gain the knowledge out of them, just the whalebone. And the black is better for that. I'm gonna hold off until I can get two more runes. When I get 2 more runes, or buy 2 more runes, then I will be able to get both of those remaining powers in that category, and I'll be able to craft 3 trait charms without any corruption. That'll be pretty good. I don't know if I'll go beyond that to try to do 4. Four also allows you to craft your own runes, but I'm guessing it probably takes a lot of whalebone. Alright, so that'll do for that for the time being. Alright. Did I miss anything down here? This is where I got that guy. Oh, hey! There is more down here. And to think I would have let you guys get away. Well, I'm glad that didn't happen. Blood of the Abel House. Alright, listen, guys. I'm going to go ahead and send you a grenade. At least we're not down in the mine. We were born to be. 3 with 1 bomb. Wow, that's left kind of a lot of debris in the air, you guys. Eesh. All swords, nothing else.
You make sure she stays where we want her. Hypatia never leaves Adderley. Remember that.
Sir, it's just that the other night she went missing, and I still don't see how she got out.
Maybe we're not clear on this. In case anyone asks, the good doctor... Let me demonstrate how...
Yeah, demonstrate this. You yutz. All these books are nothing. Orders from Captain Ramirez. Janitor Hamilton is in disease treatment until I interrogate him and decide on his fate. Got him locked up in the little plant conservatory there. Wasn't I just out in the plant conservatory? I didn't see nobody. Alright, well, this is the good doctor's office. Audiograph.
Blackouts are worse, and my dreams have taken a turn towards the disturbing. Even rest eludes me. Duke Abel seemed overprotective at first, but increasingly, I'm a prisoner in my own lab. The soldiers stationed here leave me alone, but even then I feel like I'm being watched. What really saddens me is the loss of my work. I've always thrived on my connection to the people who need me the most. The workers and their families. Each time I hear there's been an outbreak of some fever or some new condition among the miners, it pains me that I am not with them, working to ease their suffering.
Well, she sounds like a good doctor, don't you think? I think she sounds like a good doctor. What is that? A gold bar. Nice. Rune or bone charm? Nearby. Equip the heart. Where would that be? There's some downstairs. Seems to be it. Two bone charms and a rune. Downwards from here. Well, now that I've got the key, I should be able to get into the recuperation room, right? And of course, there's blood flies. I'm going to go ahead and switch back to this for now. We're just going to go ahead and pop you. Okay, that.
This is twisted.
It is kind of twisted, yeah. It's also gross. It also gives me the heebie-jeebies. What are you going to do? Incendiary bolts. Flammable rum, lots of. Good. Floaty is good.
Ugh. On orders from the Duke, anyone discussing Adhemar with non-authorized persons will be court-martialed and imprisoned.
All right. Time for smashy. Stinking bugs. 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 Good. Hair on the back of my head is sticking out. I do not handle this sort of thing well. No, sir. Solarium schedule. Tanning box. Okay, if I found somebody in there tanned to death, I was gonna freak. Just so you know. Just so you know. That's how I was gonna react. That's kind of claustrophobic inducing. Yes. Yes, it is. Feel crunchy? You'll look crunchy. Bugs. Hates the bugs. Hates the bugs. Ooh. There's a way through there. I get the sensation that y'all are going to be unpleasant. Not to worry, I have a plan. It involves setting you on fire. No, Okay, I didn't see that. It does make better sense, though. Oh, look at them just buzzing. Just buzzing out there. They're going crazy. Crazy with buzzing. Alright, you're making me nuts. Oh, there's a bone charm. Spiritual fortune. That sounds useful. Alright. Let's just equip the heart real quick and see what else is up here. Should be... Oh, I must have missed this one. Oh, it's right on top of the first thing. Nice. This area here looks good, and there's one corrupt one, 36 meters in that direction. Let's go down a little, over a bit. Okay. Combustibles, eh? Alright, well, I do still have one of these. Golly, there's a lot of you guys. Still upset. Oh, because there's one still on the wall there. I think I can breathe a little better now. Hate you. Was more flammable back here. All right. All right, let's just do a quick save before we go any further, just in case. I'm really nervous because I don't want to lose footage. Okay, well, whatever's of interest is going to be down there. Oh, there's somebody down there. Hello. Ah, talk to Alexandria Hypatia. Well, surely we can do that. There seems to be a lot of blood in here. But let's come in and say hello to the good doctor. Hello, doctor. Hello.
I've gotten something under my fingernails again. What was I working with? Iodine, perhaps?
What is it, Chauncey? You see something? You see something of value, Chauncey? Ooh, there's that bone charm.
You did well finding Anton Sokolov, my friend. The old man is with Kirinjit. Dosh was prying him apart, digging out all his secrets. Adding Sokolov's knowledge to his own. Who knows what wonders of natural philosophy Jindosh will reveal in future days. But it's time for you to come out once again. Time to play. We have need for your special talents. The good doctor's due for a trip to Dunwall because Ichabod oil is next on the list. Make haste and make this one messy. Give the newspaper something to write about and give the people of the Empire fodder for their nightmares.
So he's given orders to the Crown Killer, it sounds like to me. Less than ideal.
I didn't used to lose things like this. A disease of the memory, perhaps. A common affliction for the gifted.
True enough, sometimes.
Falcons dedicated to the diseases afflicting sailors and mine workers. But her mind is troubled.
Oh.
Is she a prisoner? She feels trapped here. Why is she not allowed to leave Adamar?
I think that's a fair question.
The music's voice begins to play on the audiograph. A chill comes over her. And she sleeps.
I see. So you're saying that when the Duke speaks to her, she becomes the Crown Killer. Is that it?
Are you a patient of mine? I'm sorry. I should know that.
I'm here to ask you about something.
Do you cover your face because you were hurt? The afflictions we treat here are more common than anyone likes to admit.
I'm not here for treatment. I'm looking for Anton Sokolov.
Sokolov? Yes, he was here for a short time. But she took him away to see Kirin Jindosh. Do you hear something?
What about the Crown Killer? The patient of yours?
The Crown Killer? That name came from the newspapers. I'm afraid I don't... Oh, yes, the murders. I was in Dunwall, studying diseases found among whaling crews. Wait, did someone just call me? I've been forgetting things. The Crown Killer is an interesting case. I feel almost sure I could help with that. It's just, I used to do such good work and now my memory is failing me. Who is that calling me? Excuse me.
I'll just take that blueprint. Okay.
The Duke must see reason. I need more patience. There's so much I could do here. Like when Adamire first opened.
She wonders if Bergamot might increase the efficacy of her black lung formula. Another
part of her is watching. Something is terribly wrong, but I can't put my finger on it.
Okay. Well, anything of interest back here? Yeah, those are all over the place. You moved. Okay.
Nasty lives, and for Vasco, her trusted assistant.
defending myself against his red fever. In time, good Vasco. In time.
Okay. So, the good doctor's alter ego is completely off her bean.
For days, days and nights, with blood fly maggots worming around underneath.
So, you know something, do you?
Are you all right?
Dr. Hypatia did this. She's the crown killer. But she's not herself. She developed a serum trying to help the miners. The first version caused horrible changes to her mind. It's too late for me, but maybe you can still save her. She's a good person.
What can I do?
In my safe, in disease treatment, you'll figure out how to make the counter serum help her. The safe code is 704.
704. Check. Oh, ow.
I've always wondered what your flesh tastes like, my dear assistant.
That can't be good. Alright, first things first, ready to blink out.
She's gone. What happened?
Oh, she's not gone! Okay. Let's just go ahead and, close that door. And leave the crazy lady in here while we go looking for the serum. If there's a way to cure her, she is not a traitor to her empress. She's a nut. But if this was done to her by the Duke, then she's just as much a victim as I am. And so I shouldn't take my vengeance on her. I should try to save her, if at all possible. Yeah, it's funny, you know, I have mixed emotions about the whole saving people thing, and then I gut people like fishes. It's a thing I do, you know? Alright, well, let's just take a gander around here, see what we can find. Oh. Is there somebody else? Lecture on blood fly fever? Meh. Else really in here at the moment? Hi.
Why? They have to know something.
Who? Who? Hey. All right.
I'm not seeing things.
If you say so. Well, full up on bullets. Seem to be using the blade for most of my work. But, nothing. Don't want to talk? He don't want to talk. All right, no problem. I will leave you to your business there, friend.
Hopefully it's inside.
Yeah, now he said it was 704, right? Notes for the counter serum. Please tell me you're gonna guide me with
book.
Guide me with objector markers, because yeah. Syringe. We need a syringe. Box of trash. Give me that. Chloroform bottle. Well, for entertainment purposes, maybe.
I finally understand it. There's a part of Hypatia that she doesn't even know about. It's always there, riding along in her mind, takes over, and forces her to use more of the original serum with some regularity. The Duke keeps her here and, if I'm right, sends her out on diabolical assignments. Hypatia is the one the newspapers are calling. A crown killer. She leaves and comes back, leaving bloody footprints.
All right.
But there's a cure, a counter serum. I'll try to administer it once I get my notes from the safe in disease treatment. Hello? Oh, Alexandria. I was just... No. It's you.
Yes, Vasco, my love. You were found out, and now we have some experiments to conduct. Come, I'll make you comfortable.
Ah! No!
Okay, well, it's definitely clear that, definitely clear that she's got to be cured or killed. Alright, well, they seem to be leading me along here good.
I hope this works.
Look, Mr. Bubbles, Adam! Sorry, I couldn't help it. All right, what do we got here? What am I doing? Use. Sorry about that. Okay. Now what? What? Oh, turn on. Oh, there you go. Let's percolate this bad boy. Yeah. The best part of waking up is something gross in your cup. Same syringe.
For her sake, I hope this works.
I'm not even gonna address it. I'm just gonna walk away. All right, so we've created the counter serum. Now we have to administer it. Oh yeah, back to sleep, you wacko.
I won't give it back.
Yay! I did something nice. And why? Because it's a loyal subject of the Empire, that's why. Okay. Wakey, wakey.
Dr. Hypatia.
Yes. I'm sorry. Something's not right with me. Maybe I contracted something working with infectious samples.
No. Someone was poisoning you. But you should be better now. I found some alchemical notes and made a counter serum.
Poisoning me?
Don't worry. I'm gonna take care of it.
Yeah.
If you need a place to lay low for a few days, come find us. I'm staying with an ally on a boat called the Dreadful Whale.
There you go. All better. Well, relatively speaking. I mean, I don't know what the heck you did with Vasco, but I'm guessing you didn't fare well. Oh well, no recriminations. Off we go. So much to do, so little time. Now, let's see. You know, before I head back to the ship, let's just have a look-see. Still full up on pistol. But there is an extra flight of stairs here. Where do you lead me? Oh, the crazy janitor left me a trap. No, thank you. Crossbow bolt. Sure. Well, this is nice. Hamilton's quarters. I'll take whatever you got. Ooh, another blueprint. Some more loot. Oh, it's wonderful. So many goodies.
What I wouldn't give to hear Delilah's skull popping in this thing.
Report to the duty officer as soon as you've finished your current patrol.
Yeah, I can see how you might have that thought, I guess. Oh, wish my capacity had already been upgraded further because so many bullets. Oh. So Hamilton actually figured out that the good doctor was acting bizarro, and he didn't take well to it. So it kind of drove him a little bit bonkers, but he was right, so he wasn't really bonkers. Now the question is, now that we know that he was right, is it possible in any way to reassure him? I think it's worth a try. Yeah. I think we could at least go in and try to chat with him and see if he can be consoled in any way.
Why? They have to know something.
We know. Joe? Joe?
Things.
I know you're not. Well, what do you think? He's kind of trapped in this loop. That's a man in distress. And he's not responsive. I can't tell him, hey, you were right. There really is a crazy person, but it's all right now. So is it more merciful to let him live in this state or to end it?
Why? They have to know something.
Yeah. Joe, as your empress, I liberate you from this horrible fugue state. Be at peace. Okay. I feel like that was the right thing to do. It was quick. It's never painless, but it was quick. What do I have waiting for me out here?
Get the body house.
This place gives me the heebie-jeebies.
What happened to that custodian, by the way? Hamilton? Someone said he went nuts working the night shift.
Yeah, he's dead now. No thanks to you.
Burnt disease treatment for his own safety. He was a janitor here as far back as the old Duke.
There you go. Problem solved. Now, I wonder. I see two guards waiting over there. Okay, that's probably bad. Probably bad. So the watchtower is gonna start shooting at me as soon as it detects me. That's a problem. Still, perhaps I can do this a different way. I don't know. I wonder who that was. Let's go ahead and get the pistol ready just in case.
Did I imagine that? No, I'm sure.
Blankety blanks.
Grand Guard personnel. Anyone caught taking medicinal supplies?
Did you? Now you have no head. How are you gonna deal with me now? And topping that off. Yeah, I could have gone inside and eaten some food, but I don't really see the need. There's just excess stuff everywhere. Somebody else, which if I'm correct will be the last guard on the island. Where is he? Aha! Yon puke.
Someone tried to shoot me in the head.
Someone successfully shot you in the head, you yutz. Alright, that's hitbox problems. That's not my fault.
Where you hiding, coward?
Ridiculous. Well, I'm gonna just take a little bit of a moment to pick up some of those bullets that have been floating all over the place because I wasted some. Oh, two. So that's good. I'm topped off. So now I can get down to the boat. And I've killed everybody on the island. So we're good there. Is there anything out here of interest? That didn't get blown up by the whale oil that I threw over here? Okay, well, it's not that anymore. Now it's a ghost town.
Are we finished? The Grand Guard could come at any time.
Yeah, I suppose so. Let's go.
can we leave this place yet? I don't like it. Ready now?
Yeah. Let's...
Yes. Let's get back to the ship.
Get out of here.
Did you find Sokolov?
No. But Hypatia was the crown killer.
What? I don't believe you.
The Duke tricked her into injecting herself with a flawed version of her serum. It changed her, but there was an antidote, so she's alive. If she remembers the murders, she'll have to deal with that.
What about Sokolov?
They gave him to a man named Kieran Jindosh. Do you know him?
Everybody knows him. The grand inventor of Sirkonos.
Then he's next. Let's hope Anton's all right.
Yeah, his Jindosh is the name on the machines that play the audiographs. Okay, let's see. Well, stealth. Detections wasn't good, but only 4 bodies were detected. I don't know how there were any bodies detected unless people saw them while I was in the process of killing them before they turned to ash. And of course, lethality. Hostiles killed, 33. No civilians. Even though I mercy killed Joe Hamilton. So his mental state was to such a degree that he was considered a hostile anyway. So good call me. All right, let's take a look at the rest of the stats here. Got all the runes, outside of shrines, bone charms. Pretty good hit of the coins, all paintings. Missed a blueprint, but not bad at all. And crafted the antidote and found the abandoned basement. So, well done. Back to the dreadful whale. Talk to Megan Foster about the best way to reach the home of Kieran Jindosh, grand inventor to the Duke of Sirkonos.
In his day, Sokolov was Dunwall's genius. His inventions transformed the city. I watched from the tower as they changed the capital into a prison, and listened as he drank and laughed, telling my mother time and again how brilliant he was. After her death, Sokolov's inventions helped a tyrant take control of the Empire. Now, all these years later, Kieran Jindosh is Karnaka's genius. The mad inventor who's given the Duke sinister machines that move like people but aren't. Clockwork soldiers that fight and kill. I've got to find out where Sokolov's being held and bring the old man back alive. Rescue one genius and kill the other before he creates an army of clockwork soldiers.
Okay. Well, assuming this doesn't...
What did they say up in Tivia? Watch the faces of those who bow the most deeply, or some such.
Yeah, that's probably sound advice.
I just want Anton back here, safe and sound.
Well, I will do what I can.
That fool come to mean so much to me.
I'll do what I can, all right? All right, ladies and gentlemen, I'm going to go ahead and... Don't make me have to pause you.
Am I being dishonest?
Can you just hush? Please, just, you're hanging out right outside my room. Do you talk all night while I'm trying to sleep? Don't make me put a bowl on your head. Ugh. Anyways, ladies and gentlemen, I'm going to go ahead and leave this part here, and we'll pick it up next time with Chapter 4. And until then, this has been Jim at the Midnight Drive-Thru saying thank you and drive through. And thanks for watching. Seriously, Megan, That is like the rudest thing ever. You just hang out outside my door and babble to yourself. Do you know, people are trying to sleep in here. It's bad enough trying to, you know, get used to the rocking waves. And, I'm gonna rock.